Welcome, friends. This is Will Whitfield with W3 Productions. What I wanted to share with you is a tutorial using dynamic paint. And what you can do with dynamic paint is pretty much a lot of things, but in particular for today, if you ever wanted to know how to make an imprint in a mesh, such as using footsteps, or in this case, in an example video, a body print, because a body cracked into a wall, you can use dynamic paint to displace a mesh and create that effect. So this file I have opened up in Blender 2.8 is kind of the remnants of that example that I just created. So I have the body here, this character from Dash Studio, and that's going to be our brush. And we're going to create a plane that's going to be the wall that he crashed into. That's going to be our canvas for dynamic paint. I have my sun lamp set up and a camera. And the only other thing we have here is an icosphere that I modified the geometry to. And all that was for, if you notice in the video, some rocks fell as the body crashed into the wall. And that's just the object we referenced for our particle system. So maybe at the end I'll show you how I set that up if you don't know how to do that already. So let's begin. Now, having a body is not important if you're trying to replicate this. You can use any kind of mesh, modified cube or sphere or whatnot. The important thing is that it's a mesh that has quite a bit of geometry, a lot of vertices to it, in order to create an accurate imprint. So that being said, the first step I'm going to do is create a plane, 3D plane. I'm going to put it in its own collection just for organization's sake. You see here on the right I have collections. The icosphere is in the rock collection and the body is in the crash test collection, the Genesis male body with all the clothing in it. So with the wall collection selected, I'm going to hit Shift A, plane. One of the first keys to many physics simulations in Blender is to have enough scale, because Blender is calculating the distances between objects and you want to have enough scale to the objects that an accurate calculation can be done. So 2 meters is not going to be good enough, so I scaled the body up by 5, so I'm going to do the plane by 10. That seemed to work for me pretty well. So I'm going to hit S, 10, enter. Then I want the wall to be vertical, so RX 90, enter, and move it up 10 units, GZ 10, enter. I'm going to hit Control A to apply the rotation and scale. Now the second key to some of the physics calculations in Blender is to have plenty of geometry. If you want this imprint to be pretty accurate to the brush, such as a body in this case, or maybe a footprint, you want to have a lot of vertices in on your canvas for it to be accurate. So first thing I'm going to do is go to edit my mode by hitting tab, hitting W, subdivide, and I'm going to enter the number 20 for right now. So that's a good start, but I think we need more geometry. So quicker way to get that going is I'm going to go to the modifiers tab, add modifier, and add subdivision surface modifier. I'm leaving it at 2 for right now and hit apply. Oops, had to be in object mode to apply it. Let's go back to edit mode. That's pretty good. I want a little bit more, so I'm going to hit W again, subdivide. I'm leaving it at 1. I think this should be pretty good for what we need. So, tab to go back to object mode. The next thing I want to set up is the have a good animation. I want the wall to be somewhere where this pre-animated character stops moving backwards. So right now, if I move the timeline, this character that I already animated in Dash Studio he doesn't stop moving until he's well past the wall. I want him to stop moving at the wall. So with wall selected, I'm hit 3 for side view. I'm kind of already in orthographic view. And I notice he stops moving about frame 60, so at 60, I want the wall to be kind of halfway through the character. So G, Y, and move it back to the point where I think the character is, you know, kind of makes a good imprint in the wall, but not too far in. G, Y, again. Make sure feet go through a little bit, most of the body. And I think that should be good. Now to set up our simulation, first we'll start with the plane. And we're going to go to the physics tab and add dynamic paint. Keep the type as canvas, because this is our canvas. Add canvas. For the simulation example, I used substeps number of 5. And then the important part is to change the surface type from paint to displace. Max displace is how much displacement can occur in total. At 0, that's turned off. I'm going to leave it at 0, but for displacement factor, it's something you're going to want to play with. I use the value of 2, and we'll see if we play with these values. As you turn it up, I think it goes maximum of 5. What value looks reasonable for what you're trying to achieve? I thought 2 looked reasonable for what I was trying to do, so I'll enter that. It might be a little overkill, but it works. Interesting that without even making a brush, it seems like the body has already made an impact in the object. It's a little weird. Anyway, we want that to also have a dynamic paint, but a type of brush. Add brush. We're going to use mesh volume plus proximity. I want, you know, areas around the body to be impacted as well. So also for the canvas, I want to, you know, smooth this out. It looks, you know, very pixelated. So go to object, shade smooth. And I think that should be it for our simulation. And then the next step would just be to bake your simulation. So bake our dynamics and go from there. I think what happened is I'm using this file over and over and it says it has 30 frames on disk. So it's probably caching from when I tried this before. So I'm going to delete all bakes just to get rid of that. And I'm going to bake again. It's going to take a little while, maybe about 2 minutes. I'm going to skip ahead and show you the results after. All right, we are back and the baking is done. So I'm just going to screw up the timeline again. Oops. The character flies through the air. And crashes into the wall. And then he kind of falls out the wall. And if we go to a rendered view, it's probably the only way we're going to see the actual impact because of the shadowing that's going to happen. So change shading to rendered view. That's going to take a little while to calculate. And we see we have the impact on the wall through the shadows. If I added a material to this wall, it'd probably show up a little bit better. But there we have it. We have our imprint in the wall. And the same thing would happen if you're trying to make footsteps. I would advise you, though, if you're doing footsteps on the ground, that maybe that landscape is very big, you're going to have a give and take with how many vertices you have for that landscape versus the time to calculate all that. You know, what's worth it? How much time is going to take to calculate small footsteps on the vast landscape versus the accuracy of the footsteps? So maybe, you know, you're seeing where you're doing actual footsteps is very close in and you're only doing a small piece of geometry versus having something that's very big, like maybe a desert or something like that, or a snowy landscape. So take that in consideration for your larger projects. Anyway, that's all for the dynamic paint using displacements. If you want to stick around a little bit longer, I will also show you how I did the rocks falling out when the person hits the wall. That's not very hard at all either. So what I did is, first thing I need to do is create a vertex group of the area where the rocks are going to fall out. Because I already have my objects, so you just make any objects, spherical-like object, and give it a rock-like texture. And then hit tab, go to edit mode for the canvas, or the wall. I'm going to go to a frame where the character is in the wall. I'm going to right-click out here to deselect all vertices. Hit 1 for front view. And hit C for like circle select or brush select, and just select all sorts of vertices around the body, the area of impact, basically. Because this is where the displacement of the rocks is going to take place. Hit enter. Then I'm going to go to the object data tab. Hit the plus sign to create a vertex group. Let's call it rocks. Have a proper name for it. And hit assign. So assign all those vertices to that group. So if I hit deselect, it deselects that everything. Hit select, it just selects those vertices. So that's part one. Hit tab to get back out of edit mode. Then we're going to go to the particles tab. Add a new particle system. Keep it on type of emitter. Let's say the number of emissions, let's keep it down to like 100. We're going to start at let's see when he first starts to hit the wall. So I think around frame 50, and like I said, we stops at frame 60, so we wanted to start at 50 and end at 60, and they can keep a lifetime of 50 frames, so the rocks will fade away at 50 frames, so they'll be off screen by then. You can see they've already started to emit, but we don't want it coming everywhere on the wall. So that's why we created that vertex group, because we're going to go to the vertex group area, and for the density, we're going to select the rocks vertex group. So now they only appear around the area that we selected, and that should be good enough for our example. For the render, we do render as object. For the instance object, we're going to select the icosphere. I just called it icosphere. I didn't rename it, but that's our object we want to emit. And we see that it already comes up a lot smaller than the actual object because it's at a scale of 0.05. I'm going to move it to 0.1. Just give it a larger rock size. I'm also going to set the randomness up to 0.75 because I don't want all the rocks to be the same size. And I think that's pretty much it, all I did. And that'll give you a pretty good simulation. So he hits the wall, a bunch of rocks fall, and then he stops. And then he kind of kneels out of the wall. So that was it. Hopefully this will be helpful for you in your animations. If you have anything to share, please leave a comment below. Be sure to like and subscribe to the channel. It helps out a lot. Thank you. Have a blessed day.